You've undoubtedly seen videos of statues across the world being torn down. It's dominated news cycles alongside the protests for weeks now. Despite the recent surge in coverage, we've been seeing this happen since 2017.
The city of New Orleans has removed the last of four monuments honoring leaders of the Confederacy.
But this movement has changed drastically since it first began with the tearing down of a memorial dedicated to the infamous Confederate Civil War general Robert E. Lee. Nowadays, statues of Winston Churchill, Roosevelt, Jefferson, and MacDonald are at risk of being removed. So how has the movement changed, and what are these activists trying to say? The movement's initial incarnation was brought about by the hundreds of monuments, memorials, and glorifications of Confederate generals and soldiers who fought for the South in the U.S. Civil War. These monuments, which aggrandize the losing side, are inseparable from the defining issue of the Civil War, the South's archaic desire to continue enslaving African Americans. Many of these sites were swiftly taken down, sometimes by democratic resolutions, but far more often by activists. In the wake of the Black Lives Matter protests that swept across the United States and then the Western world, reaching the UK, France, and Canada in a matter of days, the movement saw a resurgence. The Black Lives Matter hashtag and names of police brutality victims began appearing on statues across the US, many of them being defaced and torn down. But these statues weren't solely Confederate icons, but national heroes as well. And like the protests, this phenomenon has now spread to Canada. As early as 2018, the John A. MacDonald statue in front of Victoria City Hall was removed for what some argue are his controversial political beliefs. Namely, his mistreatment of Canada's Indigenous and First Nations, along with his views on Chinese immigration. But can we only have statues of those who are perfect in every conceivable way? Monuments are erected for leaders' achievements, and founding the nation of Canada is a pretty big one. During John A. MacDonald's time, Canadians were genuinely fearful of an attack from the United States. His vital role in Confederation unified the provinces to better defend against a massive threat lurking beneath Canada. And they had MacDonald to thank for preventing it, which is why we have so many statues in his honor. But if his whole record is to be examined, there are positives there as well. He granted all Aboriginal males the right to vote, a move so ahead of its time that it was repealed once he left politics. Although his strain of feminism would seem primitive to us now, he argued for women to receive the vote more than 50 years before it became law. Statues of Confederate generals were erected because their greatest achievement was winning battles in the name of Southern states. His life may be controversial, but MacDonald's greatest achievement is not. The country he created is the one we still live in today.
Is this really what it's come to? Erasing our history, tearing down our past. Sir John A. is the individual that built this country, and we have to stop looking at events in our past through the lens of our century instead of the century when they actually happened. He was a moderate for his time. He built a country that stood up for human rights ever since World War I, World War II, up until the present day. And it's a country that we can be proud of. And it's a country that, without our first prime minister, who single-handedly pretty much wrote our constitution, wouldn't even exist.
The president of France, Emmanuel Macron, is often seen as remarkably similar to Trudeau. But he insisted that the removal of statues of colonial-era figures will not happen under his watch. And yet this doesn't conflict with his promise to be uncompromising in the face of racism, anti-Semitism, and discrimination. Toronto's statue of Churchill wasn't erected because he orchestrated the doomed Gallipoli invasion. It was because he stood alone against the greatest evil of the 21st century. Statues of Gandhi weren't created to remember his sexist views or praise his belief in African racial inferiority. They're there to thank him for his shining achievement, peaceful protest for the separation from the British Empire. Although it's easy to see why Confederate statues should be taken down, there are thousands of statues that were erected to commemorate honorable achievements. There has to be a line between someone who is inherently evil and someone who wasn't perfect, but accomplished something great that's worthy of praise.